Salut mes amis, bienvenue. That is, welcome to a week late response to the video compilation by DPR Jones entitled, What Does Atheism Have to Offer? Now, I'm obviously just a small user. This channel only officially launched yesterday, but I find myself having to discuss this very thing quite often. You know, I've tried a lot of different religions, and I've tried them sincerely. I'm making this video actually in between reading the Book of Mormon and praying to their Heavenly Father in the earnest attempt to see if God will be revealed to me, as many Mormons claim to have happened to them. Above all, I fancy myself an academic in training, and as such, I love to acquire new knowledge. And what greater knowledge is there to have than knowledge of God, should God exist? I mean, I'm willing to hear and try any new set of beliefs out, but as of this moment, I remain unconvinced and feel nothing concerning God's existence, hence my atheism. However, I am willing to change, should my experiences demand it. Before going too off topic, I'd like to share a brief account of my experience with Christianity in my late teens. When I was 17 or so, I considered myself a fairly devout spiritual Christian. I didn't always go to church, and I didn't follow every single Christian rule, but I did honor God the Father and Jesus the Savior, and even spread the word a little, attended Bible studies, and counseled a few family members through problems with their faith. Needless to say, I was into it, but not to the point where I was giving up my entire life to be a part of it. It was merely an important thing to me, something I highly valued. But more details on that, I'm sure, will be in future videos on this channel. Anyway, so I did struggle with the question, what if I'm not good enough? I truly had a lot of problems sleeping because I couldn't get the thought of not being a good enough Christian and being damned for it out of my head. Needless to say, this was highly stressful, especially on top of all, the entirety of the teenage experience. Eventually, I broke free of my religious bonds and began the current period of self-exploration I'm in now. I considered myself an agnostic theist for a long while, and in the broadest terms possible. I believed that there was a God, but I also admitted I had no actual knowledge of this God. Though about 2 years ago, I discovered that YouTube had far more than just the occasional silly videos. Eventually, I came upon one of the most popular atheists on YouTube, The Amazing Atheist. With his bravado and yelling, which I actually had a lot of trouble with, I was eventually exposed to the more serious theological debates happening here on YouTube. With all of this, I truly began to question the thing I had refrained from questioning, the very existence of God. When I did a lot of soul searching, I eventually realized that my reasoning and justifications for my belief weren't enough to sustain it. I, similar to Prof. MTH, can remember the exact moment I truly knew I didn't believe in God anymore. I attended the concert of a Christian band that originally came from my area. I knew them personally and was actually very good friends with them. I was the inspiration for their second album, released on a major Christian heavy metal label. I'm still loose friends with them, but it was during their prayer before they played their set that evening that I realized I didn't believe in a thing they stood for anymore. I didn't believe that anyone but themselves heard their prayer, and despite what I had normally thought that moment would be like, I felt a wave of comfort come across me. I knew I wasn't letting my emotions stand in the way of my better judgment. Since then, I've become significantly happier. I mean, yeah, some nights I still have trouble sleeping, but it's more about a lost love or a death in the family, where the neighbors are simply up partying again. God damn it. But nonetheless, these are just standard, temporary, justified reasons for having a bit of trouble falling asleep every other week, or however often it ends up happening. Contrary to what is often proposed, I feel like my life now has actual meaning. Now, of course, this is just my experience with Christianity, but it's the religion I was born into. I feel that I am much better off without it, and without every religion I have sincerely attempted this far. I remain hopeful that I will one day find one, but if I don't, I don't think I will be disappointed. At the end of the day, I can truly say that I have considered alternatives and acted in accordance with my sense of reason. At the end of the day, I can go to sleep, and when I wake up, I can value my every experience I have, the good and the bad, because that's all I'll ever get. And frankly, that's all I even want. Anyway, I'm bound to tell, and my life is far better off without the shackles of religion. Au revoir, mes amis.